Have you ever murder hoboed so hard in your campaign that you forced your DM to throw some hard lessons your way? Well, we sure did.
What will you learn? What will you learn? That your actions have consequences!
Way back in a previous episode, Torek decided he wanted a new carriage and tricked the paladin into believing a driver of said carriage was a goblin in disguise. The plan had been to scare off the driver so they could take off with the carriage, but things didn't go according to plan when it turned out the paladin knew a spell called Misty Step. So, instead of the cart driver safely running away, Alzahar straight up murdered the guy. On top of that, Torek didn't want to get into trouble for tricking the paladin, so he made sure Alzahar never found out the guy was just some innocent pedestrian. A lie that stands to this day. Our last session ended on Torek and Alzahar getting arrested for murdering the cart driver. While that happened, some guards showed up at the inn to arrest Red, who hid her new dragon in one of the rooms and straight up jumped out the window. Then, she booked it down to the docks, where she shaved her head and disguised herself as an old fisherman. She even managed to get one of the local fishermen to hire her as help on his small boat. When they were out on the water, she capsized the boat and swam back to the shore. Why? The world may never know. Anyways, after that session, the entire party got a group text from the DM instructing us to create new characters just in case. Yeah, not a good sign. So, we did just that, and became somewhat attached to the new characters we made. So much so that we were just a little okay with the idea of getting our old characters executed. As an additional note, I want to remind everyone that Alzahar was literally tricked into killing that cart driver, so he legit thinks he's innocent, while Torek simply doesn't want him to find out the truth for fear of that same paladin murdering him. On the day of the trial, Alzahar and Torek decide to hire Jim the Goblin as a lawyer while Torek sends a letter out to his father notifying him of his current predicament. While they wait, Red sneaks back in under a disguise and visits them in their cell. Torek tells her to spread word that the legendary heroes have been wrongfully accused of murder. Knowing her skill for spinning ridiculous yet convincing tales, he hopes she can rally enough people to demand their freedom. Red then goes from tavern to tavern and even begins talking on the streets, spreading the tale of Thanos the Chosen One, and how the legendary heroes who helped him not only weren't paid by the guild, but were wrongfully arrested for a murder they didn't commit. The trial itself happens later that same day because speedy trials, I don't know. Jim the Goblin arrives, and just as the court was about to begin, a tall, regal tiefling lawyer. Tiefling? Sorry, I don't know. It's a habit, stop it. Bursts into the room and sits next to Jim. The judge appears amused by the situation and is rather grateful to have an interesting case to preside over, because apparently nothing interesting ever happens outside of our situations. I know what you're wondering. How did they know our group was guilty for murdering this random cart driver? Well, despite Torek's best efforts to burn it, they found the body. What's more, there were witnesses who saw us leave town with him before he went missing. A half-elf bard named Modesty was serving as John's widow's impromptu lawyer. The first few witnesses she called forth could only provide circumstantial evidence, saying they might have seen the group with John, or they might have recognized the cart when they returned to the capital. Jim and the tiefling lawyer would talk amongst themselves for a moment before convincing the court that these witnesses were not bringing proper evidence to the case. Then, Tom Enigma from the magic shop appeared with the horse that had been pulling the stolen cart. He cast a spell that allowed the animal to testify, to which the tiefling lawyer and Jim pointed out was rather unusual since the horse was speaking so fluently that it appeared to have rehearsed what was being said. Ultimately, the horse was shot down as a witness when it revealed that it did not see the group murder John because they were out of view when it happened. Now, some of you are probably wondering how a horse can remember things from days ago when the intelligence level of an animal is so low they'd forget after about 24 hours. In this case, we've already established that animals were slightly more intelligent in this world, what with the birds having their own laws and such. So just overlook the details on this one. The last witness was actually a ledger read by a wizard who worked for the capital. And this one was a doozy. It was a witness testimony straight from the corpse of the cart driver himself. However, the spell used, called Speak with Dead, means the answers which the corpse gave were short and cryptic. At most, they were only able to confirm the identity of the charred remains. Meaning, in other words, the DM was being nice to us. Torek was waiting on someone to use Zone of Truth on them. If they did, he planned on letting the paladin answer all questions since Alzahar 100% believed he did not murder John, and that he only killed a goblin that night. However, the case didn't get that far as a man burst into the court and delivered a note to the judge. The judge laughed and announced that due to popular demand, the guild had decided to up the group to bronze level, which officially made them citizens. What's more, since John the cart driver was not a registered citizen, the group was of a higher status than he was, and therefore were not eligible for the execution sentence in this particular case. Alzahar stood triumphant, and Torek sighed in relief as they heard a group outside demanding their freedom. Red's efforts had worked, as did the assistance from their new tiefling lawyer, since Jim didn't exactly have any legal experience. Torek nodded awkwardly as his father got up and left without a word, and he grinned mischievously at the judge. Told you we were innocent.
Oh no, you're definitely guilty. This just means you owe John's widow 10,000 gold. Case dismissed.